这个哦，哐啷多的哈，这个这一个哐啷多的 electron 跟 hole 哈的，它因为它的 wave function 被 confined 在一个 very narrow region， OK， so wave function overlap between electron and hole is very strong， so if you go ahead to capture the transition matrix element that the right encode the Fermi-Gordan rule, right? Okay. But the Fermi-Gordan rule not in the holiday, that's in the quantum physics. Okay. Anyway, so this is because the quantum in a very small region, okay, so the wave function overlap is very large, so the therefore transition probability is large. So, so the emission coefficient is large too. But the, you know, you have to remember in optics, it's reversible. If the absorption coefficient is large, then the emission efficiency also large. This can be well understood because you know from the high energy level jump to the lower energy level, you just and. One is that called the emission, and then for absorption, the electron jump from a lower energy level to higher energy level. Okay, so that you have a switch the initial state and a final state. So when you make a calculation, transformation element, these two matrix element is the same. Okay, so when you calculate transition probability. And to make the clearly the explanation, said for the people who don't understand the quantum physics, I put it in this way. 假设我们把电子当成哈男生哈，电动当成女生哈。If you combine these two people together in a very small look, 哈，他们不结合才奇怪，他们结合力非常强。OK. I deposit the nail wire on top of hotonic crystal, I change the boundary condition.
Okay.
Because the boundary condition changes, the property of hotonic crystal will change.
Okay.
Therefore, the hotonic band gap will change, yeah? And that will output.
You are not saying that the photon is accumulating in the wire, no? So how is it changed that so that you can have a...
Of course, you know, that if you change the boundary condition, that would concentrate on that particular region of the narrow wire sitting on. Yeah.
That will accumulate it in some particular place?
That will come out from the particular place, because only
if
that...
If it come out from there, then there has to be something generating this light, right?
That's right. So the light is because I generate the light because I have an instant... when I do the measurement, I have the hormone to have a laser input to excite the electron hole pair.
Mm-hmm.
The electron hole pair is confined inside the
nanoparticle. So the electron hole will go there, and then we combine a less bar, and then so you have a light coming out. That's because of the electron hole recombination.
No, I believe it's that after the electron hole pair recombine and then you will generate the light, okay? And then because on top of photonic crystal, you change the boundary condition due to the deposition of the narrow wire.
Okay.
Therefore, the photonic crystal band gap is changed.
Yeah, any other questions? Yes.
Yeah. I have two questions. Maybe I can speak in Chinese.
Okay.
And then maybe my question could speak.
第一个问题是说这个 spin， 在这个 low dimension 也是有一个很好发挥的这个未来跟前景。不管是 low 或 one dimension， 那有没有考量说，如果用你的 topic 去发挥做这个 spin 的这个研究，有什么样的限制在这边，或是还有哪边必须要再去努力，才会有些突破这样子？对。那第二个问题是 ，Professor 的研究相对来讲比较应用，对，那跟我们一般概念来讲的那个 physics 是来讲的话是偏向比较应用的。那我们一般来讲 physics 都是比较很 fundamental 啊，或者很理论的那之类的。对，那为什么 Professor 特别独爱去做比较应用的嘞？那如果是这样的话，我们直接去学材料的啊，或光电啊，或电机啊，从那边开始会不会比较好这样子？那我
怎么
要从物理开始？好，谢谢。
这个不好回答的问题 ，OK， this is a very difficult question， OK， 对，我这样讲哈 ，OK， 我刚刚一开始就讲说哈，因为我们是物理学家哈，所以我们对材料的特性就了解比较深刻，因为我们对材料了解比较深刻哈，所以我们就有更有机会去设计出更新的材料，别人想不到的东西。所以你材料跟材料之间的相互交互作用，我们可以别人还没想出来看不出来的时候，又这个材料跟这个材料还有这样的特性，我们把它组合起来以后，很可能会经过交互作用会产生新的现象嘛。其他的人他们的物理直觉没有我们这么深刻，因为我们是物理学家，所以我们深刻到可以比人家能够新一步去预测到，所以我们更有机会去创造是新的现象。这是我们身为物理学家我们有这个好处，因为我们了解物理毕竟是一个很基本的科学， OK， 所以我们这是我们的优势。所以我刚刚开始我在讲都透给以前，我就刚开始讲这个，我就是说我是利用我这个物理的优势去做这一件事情， OK， 呀，那第一个问题，因为你讲到就是 nanostructure跟 spin 这个在我的研究领域我比较不熟悉 ，probably the people here can give you a better answer, right?
Okay. So any other questions? Yes.
我比较细节的问题就是在那个半导体，然后绝缘体跟石墨烯的结构啊，就是在正的，就是在半导体、绝缘体、石墨烯的结构，在正 bias 跟负 bias 它的emission 的 spectrum 会不同。
对。
可是那我刚刚看那个 band structure 不是都是在半导体那个 band structure， 为什么会有不同的 emission spectrum？ 然后如果我们有不同的 bias， 是不是也会 spectrum 会有连续的变化？
是会有变化。不过这个因为一个是 defect emission， 一个是 band gap emission。
哦，
就
是从 defect。
对 defect emission， 这是 defect， 一个是 defect， 一个是 band gap。
所以它不会有连续变化在不同。
对，它没，不过你如果相同的正偏压之下，你得到的结果大概是 spectrum 是一样，只是 intensity 不一样。
Yeah. Okay. If there's no more question, let's thank Professor Chen for his very nice talk again.